In this video, we're talking about VSEPR theory and how to use that to predict the three-dimensional shape or geometry of a molecule. VSEPR, V-S-E-P-R, stands for valence shell electron pair repulsion. And it works pretty much like this. There's electrons attached to atoms in a molecule, and these electrons, the outer electrons anyway, repel each other. They push each other apart. They're trying to get as far away from each other as they can. And there's two kinds of electrons that do this, a bond pair and a lone pair. For instance, in this Lewis structure of the water molecule, this line represents a bond pair, two electrons in there, and this represents a bond pair. And each of these two dots represents one lone pair. And so all this lone pair, this bond pair, and this bond pair, they're all pushing each other apart, trying to get as far away from each other as they can. But at the same time, there's an opposing force, and that is the positive charge on the nucleus is pulling the electrons in and holding them on to itself. And so these opposing forces, the attraction of the electrons to the nucleus and the repulsion of the electrons against each other, is what causes a molecule to have whatever shape it has. It's three-dimensional geometry. There's three basic shapes that we're going to know to deal with: linear, trigonal planar, and tetrahedral. And each of these shapes has what's called a bond angle associated with it. A bond angle is defined by three atoms that are attached to each other, like this one, and this one. And so this angle here is 180 degrees. This one's 120 here, here, and here, and down here it's 109. So memorize these shapes and bond angles. Linear is 180 degrees, trigonal planar 120, and in this shape here, let's look at it, called tetrahedral, 109 degrees. The first two shapes, linear and trigonal planar, are both flat. They lie in a plane. All the atoms are in the same plane. But this shape here, this is what happens when you have four things that are attached to a central point, like this central atom here, and they're trying to get as far away from each other as they can. They end up forming what's called a tetrahedron. And what we use to try to show this three-dimensional shape is this squiggly line means that this atom here is going away from you, back into the screen. And this wedge here and this wedge here mean that these two atoms are coming out towards you. And this line just means that the atom's in the same plane as the screen. And so this looks kind of like, with the central atom here, it has a tripod supporting it with one arm kind of sticking straight up. That's called a tetrahedral shape, and the bond angle, all these bond angles here are 109 degrees. There's two other shapes we're going to see, bent and trigonal pyramidal. A bent geometry or shape can have one of two angles, bond angles, 120 or 109 degrees. With trigonal pyramidal, it's 109. The way these come about is if you have a trigonal planar distribution of the electron groups attached to an atom, but one of these is a lone pair. See, the thing is, we can't really see electrons, we just see the nuclei. So this would look to us like like this was invisible, but it's still affecting the shape. And so this shape would be bent. That's what we call it. Down here, if two of these groups are lone pairs, we couldn't see them, but their effects would still be felt. What's left would form another bent shape, but its bond angle would be 109. And down here, if only one of these guys is a lone pair so that we can't see it, what we'd have left would be called trigonal pyramidal, like just these three guys in the bottom. That's where those come from. So here's how to figure out what the shape of a molecule is based on its Lewis structure. First step, draw the Lewis structure. You know how to do that by now. Then look at the central atom, and only the central atom. What you're going to do is you're going to count up how many what we call electron groups there are in that central atom. Now, an electron group can be either a bond pair or a lone pair. And for what we're doing here, a bond pair, it can be a single bond, a double bond, or a triple bond. Each of these only counts as one electron group. So if you have a triple bond, we only count that once as one group. And a lone pair is one group too. Once you know how many, once you have the Lewis structure, you know how many electron groups there are in the central atom, how many of them are bond pairs, and how many of those are lone pairs, then you're gonna use this table I'm gonna show you in a second, and you just look up the shape and the angles. So this is an important table, you should memorize it, put it on your card. And so what you do, the way you read this is first, since you know how many electron groups there are on the central atom, you find the rows here that have that number of electron groups. For us, it's going to be either 2, 3, or 4. Now, if it's 2, then there's just one row and you're finished. You just read everything straight across. If there's 3, then you have to see how many of those electron groups are lone pairs and how many are bond pairs. And once you know that, that's going to determine which of these rows you're in, and that's going to read everything straight across. And with 4 electron groups, there's 3 possibilities: 0, 1, or 2 lone pairs, 4, 3, or 2 bond pairs. Once you know that information, that'll put you in just one row and just read the other information straight across: electron group arrangement, bond angle, and the shape or geometry. Now, the electron group arrangement. This is the shape that the electrons make, and usually that's not as important as the shape of the molecule. The difference is in the shape, that's what the molecule looks like just being able to see the nuclei. A lone pair is invisible, but its effect is still felt. Electron group arrangement, that includes, doesn't matter if it's a lone pair or bond pair. So let's do some examples. You're gonna need this table as we go through these examples. So looking at the structure of carbon dioxide, just look at the central atom. This double bond is one electron group. This is one. So we have 2 electron groups, 2 bond pairs, 0 lone pairs. That means the molecular shape or geometry is linear and the bond angle is 180 degrees. This is the kind of thing you're going to need to know. In the nitrate polyatomic ion, there are 1, 2, 3 electron groups. Remember, this is just one. 0 lone pairs on the central atom. And so there's 3 electron groups, 3 bond pairs, 0 lone pairs. The molecular geometry or shape is trigonal planar, and the bond angle is 120. Again, we're just reading this information off of that table. For sulfur dioxide, there's 1, 2, 3 electron groups. 2 are bond pairs, 1 are lone pairs. That means that this molecular geometry is bent. The electron group arrangement will be trigonal planar, but the geometry or shape is bent, and the angle, the bond angle, will be 120 degrees. This is called methane, CH4. There are 4 electron groups, 0 lone pairs, 4 bond pairs. That makes this a tetrahedral geometry and 109 degrees. Ammonia, NH3, has 1, 2, 3, 4 electron groups, 1 lone pair, 3 bond pairs, and that means its shape is trigonal pyramidal and the bond angle is 109 degrees. Finally, water. The central atom has 1, 2, 3, 4 electron groups, 2 are bond pairs, 2 are lone pairs, and that means its molecular geometry or shape is bent, and its bond angle is 109 degrees.